Hello everyone. In this unit in 11, we will talk about ubiquitous computing, and we will be discussing about the introduction to ubiquitous computing, different types of network like audio networks, data networks, and wireless networks, and ubiquitous network. The network access control mechanisms and service-oriented network. Now, when you say ubiquitous communication is basically a base for or bare minimum requirement of any ubiquitous application to work, and these ubiquitous application need to access this bare minimum virtual computing environment or the base network to access the relevant remote external information or task or any other systems anywhere at any time. Because different ubiquitous applications require different combination of network functions and services depending on the requirement of the application, where say some Ubicom systems may require to access the data streaming, or say some application requirement need to have a minimal jitter in the network, and some may be requiring a specific media access control. Now, while designing and structuring this Ubicom application, these network communication component can be considered as an internal property of ubiquitous application, or it can be considered as the external property of the application. So, where it is considered as the internal property or an internal system, then this needs to be considered in the design itself while modeling the Ubicom application. Whereas when it is considered as external to the system, then you need not to consider as a part of this system, which is external to the systems. And the Ubicom system delegate the task of, say, virtual computing to these ICT components. Now, while working with Ubicom system and Ubicom applications or Ubicom communication, there are say two major issues based on which the decision has been taken, based on say what kind of application that you are developing in Ubicom environment. First is whether or not these communication functions are say transparent to the services. That means the design of your ICT system is say network oriented. And second is whether the issue of whether or not all these network services attached anywhere and accessible from anywhere, just in the case like we access the services from network. So it is a service based or service oriented network. So depending on the requirement, what kind of application is being designed, the network design of the Ubicom communication is based on service oriented or network oriented. Now, so let us look at the different types of network. We know these PSTN voice network that we use for our landline telephone lines, the public switched telephone network. We also use intelligent network and IP media, IP multimedia subsystem type of network. ADSL broadband also we use, like in our BSNL broadband connection, we have ADSL modems. We also use telecommunication, wireless, wide area network, and the DAC-10. We also use the audio broadcast network for our FM transmission. So let us look at all these different types of network in brief. The public switched telephone network is originally designed to support voice communication. So it was not originally designed for data and video signals. So previously the first deployment of this PSTN network was based on analog technology, and later it is transformed and converted into a digital transmission. So your backend is digital, but still use a separate network for voice and data. Although the convergence of voice and data and audio video progressing has happened, so your phone in these overall network act as the access device which enables you to use the PSTN network. And at the back end, say your service provider, take example of a BSNL which is running an exchange and providing a connections to different user. Now this phone is connected to the nearest branch exchange, and these number of say different number of branch exchange are connected to the main branch exchange, which enables you to connect the call with the destination. Now this public switch telephone network is based on a circuit switched technology, which means a source and destination, once connected, the line between the source and destination is dedicated for these two user only, because like the source and destination only can share voice data on these two line. Now even if no communication or transmission is happening between the source and destination, no other user can use that line, because the line is circuit switch, the circuit is dedicated to these two user. Whereas in case of say computer network, where we use the packet switching technology, packet switch network, the data is divided into say small number of packets and routed through different routes to the destination, where the physical channel is not dedicated between specifically only two, so like one source and destination. There may be n number of source and n number of destination using the same channel or sharing the same channel, depending on the number of packets has been sent. And at the end, these packets are assembled and put it in a proper sequence, and you form a message. So this is what the basic difference between circuit switched and packet switched network. But say one, if one talks about the quality of service between packet switched and circuit switched network, circuit switched networks always gives a higher quality of service, but at the expense of, because it may be having a scenario where no data has been exchanged between source and destination, but even though the circuit is dedicated, so we can not use the channel optimally. Whereas in case of packet switch network, you can share the channel between number of people. So this is just an example where, say, you have your telephone line, you have stations line, and there are number of PBX, and using trunk line you are connected to a central office, and then you have a PSTN network. So these cloud can be a BSNL or your service provider, or this office is a main branch exchange which is connected to different PBX, and this connection between your telephone line and the nearest branch exchange is called a local loop. So you create a local loop between the end user and the branch exchange. The second type is say intelligent network. The earlier type of digital telecommunication networks were designed to support specific services using some specialized logic, and there are certain switching network element only you can use. Now the intelligent network service model was standardized by ITUT to offer the new value addition and customize the voice services in terms of say reverse billing, or say you have a toll free number, or say you have a call waiting kind of features. So this was the whole idea behind these intelligent network service model. Now this intelligent network supports independent component based services in general purpose computer nodes rather than the special switching node, and that has opened up lots of things, like and it enables service provider to drive new services. You have IP multimedia subsystem, which is a kind of development in the intelligent network, where the focus on the development of telecom services and the application program interface rather than on developing new telecom network protocol. Now the key challenge in application layer control protocol for controlling the voice video sessions or multimedia messaging and presence over IP is say if my landline services, if we are talking about a network operator, if a network operator is running its say landline services and its mobile prepaid services onto two different hardware. Say my landline services are running on Cisco, and say my prepaid mobile services are running on Nortel. So I have to use the business support system and operational support system of landline on Cisco because my hardware is running on Cisco, and on in case of prepaid mobile services, as my hardware is running on Nortel, so I have to use my operational and business support system of Nortel itself. So there is a one-to-one coupling, there is a one-to-one relationship between what kind of hardware I am using and what kind of operational system I can use. But in case of say IP multimedia subsystem, this is basically allowing the telecom service to act as an allow these say telecommunication services to form a middleware or a API which allows or which disconnects the relation strong relationship between hardware and the upper layer. So if I have a middleware which can talk to n number of say business and operational support system and n number of hardware, then I can run my hardware on Cisco, and top of it I can have say Nortel applications for operational and business support system or any other system. So IP multimedia systems allow lots of flexibility, and that is why it is called the next generation network, which is going to replace and introduce lots of new services in the telecommunication segment. We have say ADSL broadband, where this BSNL broadband connection comes with this ADSL technology, and ADSL increases the transmission capability over existing physical network. So whatever the copper wire PSTN connections that we have, using which we can say access the data network also by just adding the ADSL model in between the computer and the standard this copper wire PSTN connection. And this, like the connections, the copper wire physical connections that has been used for voice transmission uses 3 kilohertz bandwidth, but typical line transmits a usable signal up to approximately 1 megahertz, and high frequency signals however face more transmission challenges. So the same line here basically has a dual purpose, and ADSL modem basically divides this line into two different channels, and which can be used for data and voice at the same time. So you can see here you have these local loop between your service provider and the telephone line, in between you can have a splitter and ADSL modem where you connect your computer, which allows you to use two different feature of the line. Say you can have the standard voice transmission between your PSTN and your telephone instrument, and you can have a data transmission directly with your internet service provider using TCP/IP protocol.